20 past 11 in the Europa Shopping Mall. It's November the 8th. Alan is lying relatively comfortable on this polystyrene, which is warm, and a couple of cushions which I prop myself up on. But if we put the camera on this image that I'm painting now, there's something rather beautiful that's happening here. As I say, hopefully in the day I will be able to start putting the bird's nest that this child is sitting in with some of the birds. So I'm really hoping for something rather special in this particular situation as it is. So that's where we're at. I'm pretty comfortable with everything. I've got no pressures on me. I'm painting as I feel I should be doing, and I've got great expectations of how this particular image will finish, maybe in another day's time. There's going to be a lot of work involved with the bird's nest and baby birds sitting around, but I'm hoping I can create something rather special. So that's where I'm at on November the 8th on the floor of the Europa. So there we go. It's 4:30 on November the 8th. It's been a pretty hard day. When I say hard, it's the way that I'm having to lie on the floor. Yes, I'm comfortable at times on this polystyrene, but when you're lying in a contorted position, which I am, for 3 or 4 hours, as I have been, you begin to ache, and my ribs are aching as though I've had a kick in the ribs. But this is all part of the agony and the ecstasy, as I've said before with Michelangelo. He knew what that meant. Let's just put the camera on what I've been doing today on this ground level situation. Well, as one can see now, I've clothed the child and put the body to it. And there are times on this painting when I do ask for help, make no mistake. I just feel as though I need that extra help. And I was about to think, where am I going to place birds? And automatically, as I asked for help, I got the name of Audubon come through. Now, anyone who's not familiar with that gentleman, he was of French origin, and I think he was based around the 1780s to the 1830s, that period. He was around the Louisiana state, which was originally French controlled, and he was one of the foremost, if not the foremost, painter of bird life, etc. He was an incredible man. He set off into the wilderness painting these birds that had never been seen before with such detail, and he even had the courage to have them published, and he even came to England to try and sell some of the prints, of which he did. He was a famous man, and yes, Audubon is the foremost bird painter, I would say, that's ever been. So if he was with me this afternoon, and I'm sure he will be tomorrow, because there's a few more birds to go in. If we look at this bird here, again, I painted that reasonably quick. Now, these birds are only in a rough stage. There's a lot of work to go on the birds themselves and onto the fabric of the nest. And so there's going to be a lot of work put around that place. There's going to be another couple of birds sitting here, young birds. We can see we've got baby birds here, so that's the feeling around this child. And there's a lot of work to continue with. But when I'm lying there for so long, I mean, it surprises me that some of the people who actually stop and say beautiful, and I don't know whether the word surprise is right, but from people one wouldn't expect that sort of comment. You know, from young lads that one could say look rather rough in manner, which is a wrong way to judge anyone. But when they're coming out with words like that, for myself as an artist, one must think that I'm on the right path. It's not just a painting, though, as I've said, of beauty. There's a message within this. But if people can look at this and maybe a bit removed from some of the dramatic images, it says something. It's allowing people to view this painting, although there's a coded message in it.
I had someone saying this painting's full of suffering. How do you paint it? So you see, the opinions of everyone vary from each one who's looking at it and what they take from it. So I have to respect every aspect of opinion. I'm not naive to think that everyone is going to appreciate it, but it certainly lifts one's spirit when you're lying on the floor for 8 hours trying to achieve a particular feeling, which is all part and parcel of the painting. If we put the camera to this young girl here, who's Chinese, and it's the daughter I've talked before of the other lady, now she's brought her own photographs, and I feel that child will go right next to those birds. The size of the head, the look on her face, and the mother as well. But I get a very strong feeling that this painting will find its destiny at some particular time in China. And I do feel strongly, and I've told her that I do feel that she's been placed in the picture because of that reason. Because if this went to China, the first thing they would be saying, is there anyone from China on it? Well, that would make four, actually. But it's a symbol, and that's what it's about. So I'm looking forward to doing that child's face when I've done all the other detail that's around it. It's going to look, if I say the word charm, because if we look at this girl here, I may have said before, she's going to be holding a beautiful squirrel. And there's going to be this feeling that, you know, children should be in paradise, and I'm painting them in such a situation that can only bring out thoughts of what people are saying. It's a beautiful setting, but it only goes down a few centimetres, and then we've got the tragic scene of the Palestinians and the Jewish children, which must not be forgotten. So again, it's a little bit like the weather, isn't it? It can change an awful lot, and this is what it's about. So the picture encompasses a lot of situations which are moving slowly towards the end, but still a long way to go. We're talking now with the first week of November has passed, and it's what, 6 weeks to, or 7 weeks to Christmas, and I still see quite a distance after that. But it'll be finished when it's finished, and I'm moving along at a pace which isn't allowing pressure, if I can help it, to be on me. The only pressure that I'm getting is sort of people who still every day keep bringing photos, and I'm having to say no, and I keep looking at the ones that I'm going to find difficult to find a place with. You know, someone's going to be disappointed, but considering at the end of this picture there may be as many as 450 images of children, etc., I shouldn't complain when I've done the best I can, and that's what it's all about. But I'm pleased now with another day. There's something quite beautiful looking about this young baby, I'm sure when I've done it, it will be a picture on its own, just like the other settings along the bottom of the painting. So let's hope this magic can continue. Of course it will, because my belief is strong enough to make this picture fly wherever it's got to go to. So with that, I'm going to say good evening, and we'll see what tomorrow brings.